Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Time for our next lesson. This is 3.2. We are still solving simple linear equations, but this time we're going to be using the operations of multiplication and division to solve these equations. So let's start off with a new vocabulary term. It's called coefficient. A coefficient is going to be a number in front of the variable. What does that look like? Well, if my variable is x, I could put a coefficient in front of that, such as a 5. So 5 would be the coefficient in front of that x. It means 5 times whatever that number is. So that's what a coefficient is. And we're going to see coefficients today as we are working through these one-step equations. So just a reminder of our rules when solving these equations. We want to first isolate the variable. Get the variable on one side of the equal sign all by itself. To do that, we start with the side of the variable and do the inverse operation of the number that's attached to it. Once we've done the inverse operation, we then need to balance the equation. What we do to one side of the equation, we must do to the other side of the equation. So what does a one-step equation with multiplication looks like? It looks like this. 5x, 5 is our coefficient, equals 30. Now, we need to get x all by itself. How do we do that? Well, the inverse operation. 5x is multiplication. That means 5 times x. What's the inverse operation of multiplication? It is division. So I'm going to divide. What do I divide? Well, I'm going to divide by that coefficient. So 5 divided by 5, that gives me 1. 1x. That's just x. So when I divide that, I eliminate it, and I already have x by itself. But the third step is to balance the equation. And to balance the equation, what we do to one side, we must do to the other side. Since I've divided this side of the equal sign by 5, I have to go over to this side of the equal sign and also divide it by 5. Now I bring down my x, bring down my equal sign, and I'm ready to solve. 30 divided by 5 is 6. And if I plug that 6 back in for x, I'd have 5 times 6, and 5 times 6 equals 30. So a few other examples using multiplication. 3x equals 20. I want to get the x by itself. So I'm going to divide, which is the inverse operation. I'm going to divide by the coefficient of 3. And that eliminates that coefficient. It just gives me x. What I do to one side, I must do to the other to balance the equation. So I bring down my x, bring down my equal sign, and solve on this side, x equals 7. And yes, 3 times 7 equals 21. Same thing here. We're going to isolate the y by doing the inverse operation, which is division, dividing by that coefficient. Then we need to balance the equation. What we do to one side, we must do to the other. Divide this side by 10, so I have to divide this side by 10. Bring down my variable, bring my equal sign, and solve. 80 divided by 10 is 8. And 10 times 8 is 80. One last example here. Our coefficient's 8. 8 times y equals 72. Do the inverse operation, so we're dividing by that coefficient of 8. What we do to one side, we must do to the other. Bring everything down. Solve this side. 72 divided by 8 is 9. So that's solving one-step equations with multiplication. Now we look at solving one-step equations using division. And so, again, our goal is to get x all by itself on this side of the equal sign. To do that, we must do the inverse operation. Well, it's x divided by 4. The inverse operation of division is multiplication. So you're going to take this denominator right now, You're technically going to be multiplying by its reciprocal. So you're going to take this denominator. I always use this dot beside it to represent multiplication. And we're going to multiply that by 4. Because the inverse of division is multiplication. So 4 times x over 4 would actually give me 1x. And then 1x is just x. You have 1x. It's just x. So I've isolated the variable. So when I've multiplied this side by 4, there's where I've actually eliminated this side. But I'm not done yet. Remember, what I do to one side, I must do to the other side to balance the equation. Since I multiplied this side by 4, I've got to also multiply this side by 4. So my x is still left. I haven't crossed it out or eliminated it. Bring it down. Bring the equal sign down. And then 8 times 4 is 32. So x equals 32. And it makes sense. 32 divided by 4 equals 8. Few other examples. X divided by 2. I want to isolate the x. To do so, I'm going to do the inverse operation, which is multiplication. Because x divided by 2, the inverse is multiplication. I'm going to put my multiplication sign beside this problem. And I'm going to multiply that by 2, which crosses out the 2s and leaves me with the x. Now it's time to balance the equation. What I do to one side, I must do to the other. I multiplied this side by 2, so I've got to multiply that side by 2. Bring down my x, bring down my equal sign. 12 times 2 is 24. And check it, 24 divided by 2 is 12. Next one, x divided by 5 equals 7. To isolate the x, I must do the inverse operation. Well, I have a division symbol here, so I know I'm going to be multiplying as my inverse. Multiply by that denominator. That cancels them out and leaves the x by itself. To balance the equation, what I do to one side, I must do to the other. So I multiply that side by 5. X equals 35. 35 divided by 5 equals 7. Last example here. X divided by negative 4. To isolate the x, we need to do the inverse operation. Again, it's division, so my inverse operation is multiplication. Multiply by that denominator, which cancels them out. I have the x by itself equals 6. What I do to one side, I must do to the other. So I'll multiply this side by negative 4. Bring down what's left. X equals negative 24. Negative 24 divided by negative 4 gives us a positive 6. So there are the rules. And that's the process in solving simple one-step equations with multiplication and division. So go ahead back to Google Classroom. Check out the rest of your homework. If you have questions, you can refer back to this video at any time. If you still have questions, please reach out to me. We'll see you next time.